We are applying the 2n squared for energy level number 1. Don't forget we are getting the 2 times the energy level number 1 here, and we are getting 2. For energy level number 2, it implies that we are going to obtain the 2, then we are going to multiply by energy level number 2, then after multiplying by 2, then we have that bracket there, and then we square. Now we shall end up getting our 8 as we got the 2 here. Similarly, for energy level number 3, you substitute, you get still the 2, then times the n, which is the energy level that is 3, then you square still, then you are alive mathematically, the answer you do what you want. Now we are assuming that we have covered all the energy levels in their order like that. Then we want now to find, to discover how many electrons are in each energy level. So we are seeing that if you are going to find the electrons in the energy level, you have to first obtain the electrons in the sub-energy what? Levels. So my concern is going to be in what we call the sub-energy level. Now each orbital accommodates 2 electrons. Don't forget, each orbital accommodates 2 electrons. So when we come to energy level K, which we said now is having a sub-energy level, which is here, and we are saying S is having how many orbital? It's having only one orbital. Then each one orbital we are saying is going to accommodate 2 electrons. So we have 2 electrons there. Now when we come to the P, look what the P sub-energy level, how many orbitals? We are saying 3. But each orbital, remember we are saying, is accommodating 2 electrons. This implies that now we have the 3 orbitals times the 2 here, and we are going to obtain now the 6 electrons. It implies if you are going to be with the D is going to be with the 5 orbitals. The 5 orbitals times the 2 electrons which each orbital must accommodate means you get 10 electrons. Now, if we are reaching F, now the F will be having 7 orbitals. 7 orbitals times the 2 electrons, and here we are arriving at 14 electrons. So these 2 electrons are in S sub energy level, the 6 in the P sub energy level, then the 10 are in the D sub energy level, and the 14 are in the F sub energy level. But don't forget, each orbital is having 2. So if S is having 1 orbital, those are 2 electrons. Then P, how many orbitals? 3. That is 3 times 2. Then D, 5 orbitals times 2, that is 10. F, 7 orbitals times 2, that is 14. Now let us take the idea of the electrons to what we call electronic configuration. Now electronic configuration, we have rules which are governing electronic configuration. And the first rule is what we are calling now Faber-Hall's principle, the Pauli exclusion principle, then the Hindu's or the Handy's what? Rule. Now this one is all about feeding electrons, basing on increasing energies of the energy levels. Now, this is how now Alpha Bau arranged this chemistry of configuration. Remember, in all level like for sodium, in all level for sodium, you said you have 11 electrons, that is 2 to 8 to 1. Now, if you are going to apply Alpha Bau, we are saying you are feeding electrons based on the increasing energies. And you'll find that this is now the energy level with this energy, the number in front, we are calling it the quantum what? Quantum number. So when we are feeling in A level, we shall do like that. We first put electrons there, then we are going to put electrons here, then we shall put electrons here. So we shall keep on now putting electrons in that order. So for sodium, now we are going to say we shall put the 1s first here, but each S is accommodating 2 electrons. Remember when we talked about here, our ideas are arising from there. Then we shall bring the 2S still accommodating 2 electrons. Then we shall bring the 2P accommodating 6 electrons. And finally, we shall bring the 3S accommodating 1 electron. So when you add, that is 2 plus 2 plus 6 plus 1. Those are 11 electrons. That is now we shall say that that is electronic configuration for sodium. Similarly, you can apply for potassium and then you do the work. What matters is to follow this kind of arrangement as it was forwarded by what you call the Alpha Bau. Now, when you come to Pauling's exclusion principle, this one is all about putting electrons in orbitals, and electrons, as you're putting them in orbitals,